It is called washoku, harmony food, the traditional cuisine of Japan. For centuries, washoku has represented the sense of beauty and order that the Japanese infuse in all their visual arts. In a perfect world, such tradition is preserved forever. But the course of history of this country has been far from perfect. One constant has been the presence of war.
Whether tribal or feudal or a world war, each conflict has changed not only what the Japanese eat, but how and why they eat it.
Pardon the presentation, but this meal wasn't meant to be pretty. It is a product of desperation in the city of Hiroshima.
During the war, there was not much food, so people ran to share what they had. Maybe one family had egg, another some noodles and the cabbage. Sometimes there was an oyster from the bay or a leftover pork belly. And on top, there are green onions and a sauce made of soy and sugar. When you put them all together, it seemed like a lot of food. It was cheap and filled their stomachs.
And today, okonomiyaki is served in more than 2,000 Hiroshima kiosks.
That is how our grandparents and the great-grandparents survived the war, by sharing food with a neighbor.
The yield of the field will be good this autumn, but it was not always so.
It was war that laid waste to our fields 150 years ago. We faced starvation until our neighbors in Mineyama sent us 100 bags of rice. Grand Consul Torasaburo Kobayashi said if we eat the rice, it will be gone in 2 days. But if we sell the rice and build a school, our children will learn how to build trade and make our fields once again green with grain.
Three generations later, Nagaoka is a leader in industry, agriculture, and education. And tonight, the city celebrates the wisdom of ancestors and the sacrifice that changed their path through history.
The festival is called Kome Hyapyo, 100 bags of rice. And each year, the drama is reenacted. The wars that brought famine, the donation of rice, and the decision to endure hunger so future generations could be educated.
This festival is just emphasizing the importance of education rather than eating rice every day.
Which they will do anyway. At breakfast, it is served with that pungent fermented soybean goop known as natto. At lunch, in Ahinomaru, the patriotic bento, so named because the rice and ume resemble the Japanese flag. And at dinner, as rice noodles, consumed with appreciative slurping, of course. The reverence for this versatile crop grew to new heights with the Neolithic discovery that rice can be fermented.
Here in Niigata Prefecture, we have humid summers and snow in the winter, which helps to produce the best rice for the production of sake.
There are nearly 100 breweries in this prefecture alone, and they do not hesitate to divulge their secrets. It is the rice, koji mold, and yeast that create superior varieties, they claim, and they're willing to prove it each year at the Nagaoka Sake Festival.
We have the best water, so the sake is the best.
And these folks agree, Niigata residents consume more than twice as much sake than the average Japanese adult each year, about 6.5 gallons. At the end of the evening, there are more than the usual number of flushed faces and communal kampais to celebrate the gifts of another season of gold. And so the reaping is done, the fields are fallow, and winter approaches. The meal is imoni, a rich stew of beef, taro, and green onions. Villagers bundle up and share their garden pickings in the community kettle. With war now a distant memory, the ingredients are heartier, the stew thicker. But what has remained unchanged is the bonding over a steaming pot, into which each villager has contributed a morsel. And so another toast to the meal in their fields, this time shared in an era of peace.